They're playing basketball
all around the
we
world.
Are their basketball.
To the beach,
they're
y'all.
They're playing basketball.
Let's go. All around the
we
world.
Are their basketball.
Y'all know this is so, so dead.
Video on transformations, so we'll be covering translations, reflections, and rotations. First, we want to talk about how we describe them. So we're given a pre-image and we want to go to an image. First off, you need to know which one is the pre-image and which is the image. Your pre-image, which is your first shape, your before the transformation, is going to have regular letters, so W, X, Y, and Z. Your image uses prime notation, so W prime, that's what that little dash is called, X prime, Y prime, Z prime. To describe a translation, all we're gonna do is we're gonna pick one point. I'm gonna pick X, and I'm gonna pick the corresponding point in your image, so X prime. I'm gonna count how many units I moved to get from X to X prime. So I'm gonna go ahead and start, and I'm just gonna say 1 over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units to the right. And then from here it went 1 unit down. So to describe a translation, you're just saying which direction and how many units did the first shape slide to get to your second shape. So that is your translation. For reflection, we're gonna once again start with our pre-image, which is gonna be our regular letters A, B, C, and move to our image A prime, B prime, C prime. For your reflection, all we're looking at is what did it flip over? So if I start here with this shape, I'm gonna imagine it flipping to get to my second one, and in this case, it's going to be flipping over this line right here, which is your y-axis. So if we're describing a reflection, all we have to say is it was reflected over the y-axis. Most of our problems, your reflection will be either the y-axis or over your x-axis. And then our last one is our rotation. Once again, we're starting with our pre-image and we're rotating to our image. I'm going to pick one point from my pre-image. I'm going to pick E. I'm going to draw a line straight to the origin, since that is what our point of rotation is almost always going to be. Pick the corresponding point in your image, so E prime, draw a line straight to your origin, and then we're going to notice what shape that makes. In this case, it makes an L, so I know that's got to be 90 degrees. And then the last thing I have to determine is which direction did it turn. So you have two options here, clockwise, so going with the clock, or counterclockwise, going against it. So it went from E to E prime, so I'm going to draw an arrow between my L there. And I see that's going the same direction that a clock would. So this is 90 degrees clockwise rotation. And now you know more.
Hey, Gossam here. So let's go check out the transformations, how to do this algebraically. So if we're looking at this first question here, it says it's going to be a triangle. Here are your three points. And then we're going to reflect it over the x-axis. So in class, what we've been talking about is when you reflect over the X, Y changes. So in this case, we're going to change all of the Y parts of our each point. So I'm going to say this again. When we reflect over the X, the Y changes. So I'm going to like draw the rule up here so you can see that. So this is kind of a representation of what's happening. So if it reflects over the X stays the same, and the Y changes sign. Doesn't mean it stays negative. It means if it's positive, it becomes negative. If it's negative, it becomes positive. So all the X values stay the same. So 1, negative 2, and 4, they all stay the same. And then all of the X or the Y values, they change the sign that they are. So if this is positive 5, it becomes negative 5. If this is positive 1, it becomes negative 1. And if this is negative 5, it becomes positive 5. And these are your new points to your triangle. So this is your pre-image, and this would be the image afterwards. And if you plot these points, you would be able to see that it would reflect over the x-axis. It would reflect over this axis. So that's how you would do number 1. So let's go ahead and look at number 2. So number 2, these are rotated 90 degrees clockwise. So for the rule for that, it means you need to flip them and x changes. So it is flipped and x changes. So if we have, it would be this rule. So they flip and then the x value changes. So let's look at each one of these. So what I like to do is kind of do this in two steps to get to our final, because sometimes that will help out so that way you don't mess up your negatives or anything like that. So first of all, it flips. So I'm going to flip each one of these. Okay, so I'm going to say 1, 5. I'm going to say 2, sorry. I'm going to say negative 8, 2. I'm going to say negative 3, negative 6. So I flip them, and now I'm going to change all of the x values that were currently. So since I flipped them, these are all the ones that I need to change. So I'm going to say 1, negative 5. Negative 8, negative 2, negative 3, 6. So this would be your final shape that is rotated clockwise. And then your last one is a triangle that is translated 2 units down and 4 right. So what I would do for that is we would write the rule that's happening from that, which would be, if it says 2 units down, that's y minus 2. And if it's 4 units right, that's x plus 4. So that way it's saying this is what you are doing to your x, this is what you're doing to each y value. So if we're coming back to our points, so all of the x values, I would add 4. So we would add 4 to 9, which would give me 13. Then we would add 4 to my x on this one, which would be 6. And then we would add 4 to this one, which would give me 2. And then I'm going to go back and do all the y values. So y minus 2. So we're going to subtract 2 from negative 3. So negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. And negative 5 minus 2 is negative 7. So this would be your final figure after you would translate it 2 down and 4 right. If you needed to, you could always draw the graph, plot the points, and then move it if you don't know the rule. So you could always do that. You could always go back to graphing it first and then doing that, and that's going to be what Ms. Gardner talks about next. So this is how you do it algebraically, and now you know.
All right, so to finish up transformations, we're going to go over how do you create the image from the pre-image. So here we have a triangle here, and we are just going to label, I'm going to label these points A, B, and C, just to kind of help me out. And so the first thing that they ask us to do is we want to translate the image 3 units to the left and 4 units down. So we know by now that a translate means to slide. So the easiest way to do this is to just take each point, A, B, and C, and just move it 3 left and 4 down. Because if you do the same thing to all 3 points, your triangle should be congruent and the same. So I'm going to start with A here. 1, 2, 3 left. 1, 2, 3, 4 down. I'm going to go with B. 1, 2, 3 left. 1, 2, 3, 4 down. And then C. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. I would redraw my triangle, and I would label my image as A prime, B prime, and C prime. Now, if you wanted to, instead of doing all 3 points, 3 to the left and 4 down, after maybe your first one, after you went from A to A prime, you might be able to just redraw the triangle just by looking at the dimensions, so I can tell that this one is 4 units tall and then it's 3 units wide. So I could have done that, but this is kind of the way that you'll never mess up if you just do it this way. So that's translations. And then, so for this one, we're asking to reflect over the x-axis. So here's our x-axis. We still have the same triangle here, ABC. And we reflecting, we can think about as flipping it. So the way I like to think about it is two different ways. Either one, you can think about this being a mirror, and then on this side is going to be your reflection. So everything should be opposite. So if you look in a mirror and you raise up your right hand, in the mirror you'll be raising up your left hand. Or you can think of this as like a giant piece of paper, and I'm going to fold my piece of paper, and the crease is going to be right here on the x-axis. So where this triangle ends up on this side should be exactly where it would be if you were to fold it over. So reflections aren't too difficult either. It's just we need to make sure that the image at each point, A, B, and C, are the same distance away from our line of reflection on the above it and below it. So I'm just going to start with the points closest to the x-axis. So if B is one unit above the x-axis, when we reflect it over, that means it should be one unit below it. And then the same thing with C. It's going to stay on the same x equals 4, but my y value is going to change. So instead of my y being a positive 1, it's going to be a negative 1. And then up here, if we look at point A, I can tell that it is at 5. So when we flip it over, or we reflect it over the x-axis, it should be at negative 5. So that point is going to be A prime. I'm going to redraw my triangle, and now when we look at it, we can tell that we have successfully reflected our original image or our pre-image over the y-axis. So that is our reflection. And then one more that we have is a rotation. So we want to rotate this image, and this time we want to do it counterclockwise. So again, we're staying with our same triangle here, ABC. And the way I like to think about clock is you go from 12, 3, 6, and 9. Those are kind of your main parts of a clock. So clockwise would go in the order that time goes, but here we want to do counterclockwise. So we're going to go backwards, opposite of a clock. Now, anytime, especially in the eighth grade, if they tell us to rotate it, we can just assume that we're rotating around the origin. So we can do this one or two ways. You could, as Mr. Gosselin explained how to do it algebraically, you could just figure out what the new points are and replot those. But if you have a right triangle and it's kind of in the corner here, like at 1, 1, we could probably just do this in our head if we think about it very carefully. So I'm taking my triangle and I'm actually going to turn it this way. So as this is kind of standing up, it goes from 1 to 5. So that means it's four units tall. When we turn it, it's now going to be on its side. So B is going to stay here at negative 1, 1. So this will be in the same spot, but now my triangle will be laying over. So that means A prime is going to have to be 1, 2, 3, 4 spots, or 4 units, away from B. And when we turn the triangle, if it was 3 spaces wide, that means when we rotate it, that means it's now going to be 3 spaces tall. So C prime is going to be 1, 2, 3 spaces above B prime. So here is my new triangle. And if we look at it, we can tell that we did it correctly. We took our original triangle and we turned it 90 degrees counterclockwise. If you wanted to check your work, let's see if this piece of paper, well, this piece of paper is not big enough. But what we could do is, if I just wanted to put it in the corner here, just draw it on the part of the paper we do have. If we wanted to check it, since we're rotating around the origin, if you turn your triangle right there, we can tell that we did a correct rotation because these parts of the lines fill in for that missing spot of the triangle. So that is a great way to check to make sure that you did the correct rotation. And now you know more.